Hello there, and thank you so much for joining us once again for our weekly business roundup. My name is Violet Sasia, and we are joined by Paul Busharizi, who is going to help us dive deeper into events happening in the world of business. So thank you very much, Paul, for joining us. And let's start first and foremost with the report by the Ministry of Finance about an increase that was registered in maize exports. Why is this so, and why was it not like this in the past? Plus, how best can we maintain this and also increase the productivity of other produce?
No, it's a positive thing. People may not know, but there was a time when coffee accounted for more than 50% of our total export earnings. Now that maize is, I think we can safely say that maize has always been an export, but it was probably being exported unofficially. Now the official figures are showing that it is catching up to coffee. I'm sure there's still a lot of unofficial export of maize. So it's a good thing that we're diversifying our export receipts so that if one fails, well, the model, our agricultural model mostly in Uganda is we use smallholder farmers. So the smallholder farmers grow their stuff, bulk it, we bulk it, and then we export it. If we are, for example, to fight poverty in the rural areas, this is probably the best model, rather than evacuating hundreds and thousands of villagers and having huge farms which can and then the wealth will not be spread around. I think this is the way to do. They just have to improve their productivity, the quality of their output, and get organized as farmers, and I think it's the best way to go.
Let's now talk about the parish development model. Now that you mentioned that farmers need to be lifted up, need to be supported to have the best produce, just like maize is performing, President Museveni is asking why people are not reaching out to the PDM to pick the money that was allocated for that purpose. What do you think is the problem, the hindrance, and how best can this money be utilized to make sure there is better produce?
Well, first of all, the PDM model is not only about money. It has several pillars. I'd have to remember how many pillars there, but there are several pillars, among which, in my mind, the important ones are really mindset change and data collection. With mindset change, you'll be able to shift the subsistence farmers away from subsistence farming to commercial farming, which is not as easy as it sounds. And with data, the country will be better able to plan for these rural populations. There's a lack of data coming out of that side. Guess. We just guess who are many people there and what they do and stuff. But those are the two major pillars that will take. Money will help, but if these other two pillars are not in place, then the money doesn't count for anything. They'll squander it and it will be done.
Thank you so much, Paul, for that insight into the PDM. Let's now talk about the African Continental Free Trade Area Agreement that was signed about 2 years ago. But according to Olive Chigongo, she says that the Chamber of Commerce has noticed that it's not really being used. And this comes at the right moment discussing this. We have a war in Sudan. Congo has been having political issues as well. The border to Rwanda was closed and opened recently. In Kenya, we had a couple of products bounced. So how come Uganda is not really looking further beyond this African region to utilize the AFCFTA, as the Chamber of Commerce is saying?
Well, the African Continental Free Trade Area was only launched about 2 years ago. And the barriers to trade within the continent are mainly, of course, because of our political boundaries and the barriers that come with that, non-tariff barriers and all that kind of business, differences in language, cultures, all that kind of stuff. So these boundaries have been here for more than 100 years. Since I think, was it 1886? So it would be a bit rash of us to think that in 2 years we can start trading with Africa. However, we see that it's so possible, like with the East African Community, which has been, I think, it's been a customs union, I think, for almost 20 years now, which means that we can have the free movement of goods and services within the region. It's shown an increase in our inter-regional trade by more than, God knows, probably more than doubled over this period. So it's a matter of time. It'll come. We shouldn't panic.
All right, so thank you very much, Paul, for making time. Also, we would have loved to talk about more, for example, tax evasion by multinational companies, but we do not have enough time. So for next time, And until that time, we see you. So thank you very much, dear viewer, for making time to catch the Business Roundup once again here on the news. Until next time, I am Viola Xasia.